achieved. So now we're going to talk about a couple of different ways that we want to measure our progress. And I want to start with objective measuring tools, because objective measuring tools are the things you're more familiar with. The things like the scale, measuring tapes, even, you know, a body fat reader of some kind would be an objective tool, like a scale, or, you know, calipers, which are what we used to use before we had those handheld body fat trackers. Or even, you know, taking a photo. You know, taking a photo can be subjective because you can manipulate it and make it look in different ways. But, you know, I've seen in my practice as a coach that using photos can be very powerful, especially when someone has gone through a very lengthy process of losing weight and they want to kind of track their progress. So, other than the scale, the other really important objective tool that I like to use is a measuring tape. Now, when I use a measuring tape, you can do all different kinds of sites. You can do your neck, you can do your shoulders, you can do all of them if you really want to. But if you're someone who's just getting started or you don't want to have to go through that process every 2 weeks, there's two major sites on your body that you want to measure at all times. And I'll explain why that's important in a minute. But you want to measure your neck and you want to measure your waist. So when you're measuring your neck, and let me first explain why those two sites are so important. When you measure your neck and you have a lot of fat to lose, you're gonna lose fat there, right? There's not a whole lot of muscle in your neck and there's not a whole lot of muscle in your waist. So you're not gonna get kind of mixed signals from your body that in an area where it might be building muscle. Like for instance, with my male clients, a lot of times what will happen is they'll actually build muscle in their chest, and so their numbers will go up, and you know, I'll talk to them through it and say, hey, that's actually a good thing, right? And we'll also track body fat to see that we're losing body fat. But for people that aren't as aware or that are doing on their own, they might actually look at that as a negative without explanation as to why that's actually a positive. So by picking the two most important sites where you're gonna see fat loss, the waist and the neck, I think that you can basically start off there, see really good results, and not worry so much about whether the measurements are going up or down. Because if you're losing fat and you're losing it in your neck and you're losing it in your waist, you're going to see the number go down, right? You're not gonna build a lot of muscle in your neck unless you're like dedicating a whole bunch of time to doing some type of weightlifting with your neck. So those are the two areas that I like to use a measuring tape for, because again, those areas are not gonna have a lot of muscle. If you're losing inches in those areas, it's definitely fat. All right, so that's an important thing to remember.